When people are exploring what type of business to start, they're told, follow your passion. And I'm going to tell you why that may not be the right advice to heed. It is completely true that if you're doing work you enjoy, you'll never have to work a day in your life. That's not the same thing as just picking something that you're passionate about and actually being able to turn that into a viable business that makes you profit, and especially that makes you enough profit to live on. What you really need to do is think of a Venn diagram. And you know those Venn diagrams where maybe there's three circles that overlap, and the section in the middle is what you need to be looking at. You want to, yes, look at your passion, because if it's something that you enjoy, you're going to be more enthused about it. And believe me, when you're starting a business, you need a high level of enthusiasm to keep going through all the hard work you're going to have to do. You also want to look at, though, finding a piece of that that you can charge money for and that people will buy. So you have to have at least those three things. Something that people will buy because it fulfills their need, and it's a need at a large enough scale that there's enough people that will buy it to support you. So you have to go beyond just what is your passion. And while it's great to follow your passion, you have to think strategically beyond that. And you can't just think, would somebody pay me for this? Yes, they might. But you also have to make sure that you find a potential audience that is big enough and that would pay for what you're providing at the right level that would support you in making a profit for your business large enough for you to live on. People always talk about, finding a niche and a small niche, and that is exactly what you need to do. But it can't be so small that there's not enough people in it. If I'm selling something really obscure and I don't even know what it would be, I'm selling frogs, okay? Are there enough people who are going to buy frogs? Can I charge enough for a frog so that the number of people who are going to buy can support a profit for my business big enough to support me and my family? First of all, I have to think, maybe, oh, sure, maybe I love frogs. They are really cute. People can also catch their own frogs in the wild. So are my frogs different enough, exclusive enough, maybe a rare breed of frog that people would want to buy them? Perhaps, yes, they are. Are there enough people in the world who would want to buy my frog? Maybe only five people realistically in the world would ever want to buy my frog this year. Okay, great. Maybe those five people can support my business. How much can I charge for that frog? If I can only charge $10, then those five customers, there's no way they can support my business. If I can charge $10,000, five people, that comes closer. Now we're talking. Even though frogs may be my passion, they're not. It's just an example. They're cute. They say ribbit. They're great. Frogs may be my passion, but that's not the only thing I have to look at. Can it be monetized? Is it a product or service that people need and want? Does it solve a problem for them that they can't get solved elsewhere? Can I offer it at a high enough price point to provide a profit for my business that's good enough to support me as an income? And are there enough people who will buy it at that price? So, yes, I highly recommend you follow your passion, but how you choose to implement your passion in your business may have to pivot a bit to make it actually a viable business opportunity and not just a hobby that you sell on the side. There's a lot of ways that you can turn your passion into a profitable business. For example, one of my passions is ballroom dancing, and I have taught ballroom dancing. I only closed my studio when we were looking at moving. Another business that's related to my passion is ballroom dance shoes and accessories. It doesn't have to be that closely limited to strictly the thing that's your passion. You can get creative and find ways to solve people's problems using something related to your passion. Focusing down on this type of product and service offering that will tick all of those boxes is one of the many services we provide with our focused marketing strategies, and we would be happy to help you pick the right product or service for your business and your customers. Do you have a marketing question? Drop it down below or visit our website, vickiwoo.us. You can also Google search for Vicky Wu Marketing Guru and find our website that way. In the bottom right corner, you'll see a chat bubble. You can click on that to ask your marketing question there. We'll try to respond to you directly, or we may use your question on an upcoming episode. While you're here, check out our other videos and subscribe to our channel so that you never miss the latest marketing tips.